Come on in. Come on in, everybody. It's our time. It's our time for the word. So come on in, tag and share. Y'all know how we do it. Please make sure you like, tag, and share. Let someone know that we're here and we are getting ready to share just for a few moments of our time of Tuesday talks. So make sure you go in and let someone know that we are online and we are ready to share. We are ready to share tonight. I pray that everybody's had an amazing day. I pray that you have been able to get through this day. It's been a little chilly. It's almost time for that good old chilly weather kind of food. So go ahead and let's just get ready because fall is here. Fall is here. All right. Make sure you're tagging. Make sure you're sharing. Good evening, everybody. Good evening. Good evening, Sharita and Michelle and Miss Remati and Arletta. Thank you all so much for being on and being on time. Again, we don't hold you long, but we do just enough just to drop a nugget on you. And prayerfully, it'll be a nugget that will bless your life in some shape, form, or fashion. I always want to talk about something that I know will be beneficial to not only myself, but for those of you that will tune in and share with us. And so we're just encouraging you to do that. How's everybody? Raven, Sharita, I think I spoke to you already. I think I did. And again, if you have, I'm trying to share to my other pages. So that's why I'm kind of just talking while I'm trying to do two things at one time. But we're going to get ready to get started. Amen. All right. All right. All right. Good evening. Good evening, Miss Diane. Good evening, Miss Rebecca. Good to have you all on. So much is going on. I was trying to check out another live that Dr. Pack was teaching a few moments ago because I very seldom get a chance to get fed. And so I was enjoying that. And so I almost was late to my own party. But we're here, and we're thankful for each and every one of you. So again, this is our Tuesday talk, and so we welcome those of you who have come to be a part. This is the time again where we come to drop a couple of nuggets, and prayerfully it'll be something that will bless you. And so we say good evening once again to everybody. Today I want to talk about what's defining you. Good evening, Jennifer. Good evening, Starsha. I want to talk about what's defining you. What's when people see you, whenever even your name is mentioned, whenever your name comes up in a conversation, how are you being defined? What is it that people say when they think of your name? What is it that what's that thing that carries weight, you know, on your name? You know, how do they speak of you? Do they speak well of you, or do they talk, you know, in a manner that I don't know about her, you know? So sometimes everybody kind of got that little thing about them sometimes that people may like, I don't know. So what defines you, or what is defining you? And I thought about this subject whenever I was cleaning up the house a few days ago, and I was sweeping up the floor in the kitchen area. And you know, we were taught whenever you sweep up the floor, you sweep from the corner, you know, inward. You go from the corners and you go in, and you make sure, you know, you gather everything in the middle of the floor, you know, before you get it on the dustpan. You kind of get a good little bit in the middle of the floor, if anybody's still sweeping floors. And so I was sweeping up the floor one day, and there was a little pile that was, wasn't a large pile, but it was a little pile in the middle. Good evening, Sister Monica, but Sister Tammy. There was a little pile in the middle of the kitchen floor, and as I was sweeping up, I was noticing these little remnants of different things that I was sweeping from the corner because stuff drop when we're cooking, stuff drop when we're preparing, stuff drop when we're taking something out of the trash can and putting it into the big trash can, so you might have a little bit of anything that's under the edge of the stove, that's under the edge of the refrigerator. You may have little remnants, basically, hanging all around. And so as I'm sweeping up, my trash in the middle, before I put it on the dustpan, I see a little cornflake, that's in there. I saw a couple of strands of hair that came from the bathroom. I saw a leaf from a plant, a plant that had kind of withered a little bit and had dried off, and I saw a leaf in there. So, I start seeing all these little remnants of history, from my life, from my house. And when you start to look at the remnants that had gathered in the middle of the floor, that dirt tells a lot about what has happened in your house. It tells a lot about, what has taken place over the course of the last week or a couple of weeks or however long it's been since you swept up your floor, so to speak. And so, but that dirt is not the sum total of my household. I hope you hear me. Even though it's remnants from things in my household, but it's not the sum total of my household. It's not the sum total of who I am. It's not the sum total of who I have been. It just reveals only remnants of my truth, if you will. It does not define who I am in totality. And so you if you look at it from this perspective, if somebody would have come in my house at that particular time when I'm sweeping up the floor, and before I could put everything up on the dustpan to throw away, if somebody would have come in my house and saw just that thing, just that dust that was in the middle of my floor, just that dirt that was in the middle of my floor, and looked at nothing else in the house, absolutely nothing else, they could have went there and leaving saying, "Pastor Mo, show keep a dirty house." Because all they saw was the dirt in the middle of the floor. I hope you all see what I'm saying. They did not see the living room that was spotless and had been cleaned. They did not see the bathrooms that had been cleaned and the trash taken up out of the bathrooms. They did not see, the dining room where the crystal and the china was spotless. They didn't see the bedrooms where the beds were made up. Only thing they saw was that there was some dirt in the middle of my floor, and from that, they really could have gone back and given the testimony and defined how I keep my house. Does that make sense? So I would have, and the reason they didn't see the rest of the house, hear me, because I did not invite them into the rest of the house. The reason they didn't know the living room looked like it was, or they didn't know the bedrooms were as they were, or they didn't know the dining room was as it was, because I did not allow them into the rest of the house. And therefore, I allowed that one spot and that one moment to define how I keep my house. I hope you hear what I'm saying. What I'm trying to say is, in the spiritual, many of us are defined by that dirt pile that's in the middle of the floor. I hope you see what I'm saying. We are not allowing people into our lives enough to see the beautiful places in our life. We show them the dirt, and we allow them to see the negativity, and we allow them to see, the stuff that doesn't make us look so good, sometimes. We show them, our ugly disposition. We show them our bitterness and our hurt. Come on, we do it personally as well as virtually. You know, sometimes when you see people, all they put up is negative stuff. All they put up is some subliminal messages throwing shade, but you don't know the sum all of who they are. You know, you don't see the soft side of them. You don't see the passionate side of them. You don't see the giving side of them. Why? Because all they have allowed you to see was that small little area of dirt in the middle of the floor. Amen. And so we define them by what they show us, not who they really are. I was thinking about this earlier today. I was looking at someone's video, and it was a couple that had gone live. And so they were reading comments as the comments were coming up. And some lady in the comments just kept saying to the husband, you know, he sure is moody, but he really wasn't doing nothing, you know, that would even indicate that. And it wasn't even on there, but you know, a couple of seconds, had been on there maybe 5 minutes, and she started saying stuff like, you know, he sure is moody. And so he just kind of laughed it off, and he said, you know, she really on me today. You know, how in the world does she deduce, you know, that I'm moody? Well, it was a story that his wife was telling about something that had happened previously, but in that 10 minutes she had defined him as a moody man. And believe it or not, when people don't see the rest of us, they define us by the least thing that they see. You know, if that makes any sense to you. You know, so sometimes we allow the negative stuff to be seen more than the positive stuff. That's the point I'm trying to get to. We allow the, you know, the hurt to come through. We allow the pain to come through more than we allow God's light to shine through. If that makes sense. If somebody catches you on a bad day and you respond to their kindness with bitterness, and you never allow them to see anything else, that's how they're going to define you. Are you hearing me? You know, you don't want to be defined as that type of person. That's not who you are. That may have been how you came across in that moment, or that may have how you came across in those couple of days, but that's not all of who you are. And understand that may be how somebody is defining you, because that's the area of your life that you've invited them into. Does that make sense? Yeah, that's why the word says to let your light so shine among men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. But if you are never allowed the sun to shine through you, they never see anything but the darkness that you allow them to see. And so sometimes when people are what you call casting judgment on you, they are casting judgment based upon what you have allowed them to see. Amen. 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 So I need you to put that in the comments. You got to let the S-O-N shine through. Come on, I need you to put that in the comments. You've got to let the S-O-N shine through. Amen. 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 You got to let the S-O-N shine through. Praise his name. Amen. So that when you are having a bad day, you're not defined by that bad day, because you've allowed the sun to shine through so many times before. So when you're having a low moment, you're not defined by that low moment, because you have allowed the sun, the S-O-N, to shine through so much more. So that when you are, you know, doing something a little extra than you normally would, you're not defined by that extra, because you have allowed the S-O-N to shine through so many times before. Amen. It's important to allow the sun to shine through more than anything else. Amen. Because, amen, your witness is on the line. Yeah, your witness is on the line. Many of us, we are allowing so many other things to define us, though. We are allowing so many other things to define us. We are allowing, you know, we are allowing, excuse me, yeah, we are allowing our
attitudes to shine through when we really, really, really should not. We are allowing, we want people to see how busy we are and how much we are involved in. We want those things to define us. Many of us wants to be defined by our education. We want to be defined by how many degrees we have on our wall. Many, many people want to be defined by their positions and their titles. Amen. Amen. But that's not all of who we are. That's not the sum total of who we are. That's why I never really get caught up, you know, when people call me one title or another, because I know that's not the sum total of who I am. I've even had, you know, people to run down all the titles, you know, pastor, evangelist, elder, overseer, reverend, doctor. It's like, it don't matter. Pick one, choose one, because that's not that's not all of who I am. We got to make sure that we are not defined by the remnants of our life, because that's not all of who we are. The sun that should be shining in us, amen, should take precedence, amen, and set the standard as to who we are. Let me say that again. The sun who should be shining through us should set the standard as to who we really are. Amen, somebody. Amen. We're busy trying to be defined by our outer appearance, but we're not working on our inner man. Amen. Amen. We want to be defined by our jobs. We want to be defined by the money or our social media presence, but we're not actively working on who we really are and what really and who really defines us. We want to be defined by what folks see on the outside, but too much of the hurt and the disappointment and the anger and the fear that's in our hearts shines through even more than he does. Amen. And therefore, we are being defined by what we allow people to see rather than who we are in our totality. Amen. Amen. We live in a society where everything is behind a mask. Everything is behind the mask. We hide our smile behind the mask, you know, because we got this mask on. Sometimes we speak to folk. Sometimes we don't speak to folk. Amen. Amen. We don't carry on the conversation because we feel like because they can't see us, it don't really, really matter. But before we let the devil win, we've got to let the sun, the S-O-N, shine through in our lives. Amen, somebody. Amen. 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 1 Peter 3:4. 1 Peter 3:4. That's just a text of it. But it says, don't be concerned about the outer beauty or the outward beauty that depends on fancy hairstyles, expensive jewelry, or beautiful clothes. You should be known for the beauty that comes from within, the unfading beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is so precious to God. Peter says we should be known for the beauty that comes from within, not from our outer exterior, not from our hair, not from our jewelry, you know, not from the clothes that we wear, but from that inner thing that comes from within, that thing that gives us, that makes us a gentle and a quiet spirit that is truly, truly precious to God. Amen. And Peter was not discrediting the fact, you know, that we should fix our hair. He was not telling us that we should not, you know, wear nice clothes or nice things. But he was just saying those things should not define us, you know, but our spirit should. Our spirit man should. Peter describes the true character of true beauty is a gentle and quiet spirit. And so everything that we are, everything that we do, you know, amen, should be, should not be the sum total, you know, of ourselves individually, but all that we've gone through and all that we've encountered and all that we've accomplished, that makes up who we are. The one who lives on the inside of us, he sets the standard for who we are. Amen. If everything that you are is due to everything that you've gone through and where you are the sum total of your past and your present and the one who lives on the inside. That the pain of your past, you know, may have left you with some wounds, but your past also taught you some very valuable lessons. Amen. And so you take those lessons, add it to the one who lives on the inside, and it really makes you a beautiful testimony in the eyesight of God. You see what I'm saying? It all goes back to your witness being on the line. It all goes back to your witness being on the line. And so you simply have to know who you are in totality. You're not your past. You're not your hurts. You know, you're not your accomplishments by itself. You know, you're not your house. You're not your car. You know, you're not your exterior, your beautiful clothes, and all of your great accomplishments. That's not who you are individually. But the sum total of who you are is who He has created you to be. And you've got to know exactly who you are. You have been fearfully and wonderfully made because of Him. You are a joint heir with Christ because of Him. You are a part of a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people because of Him. Woman of God, you are a woman of virtue. Man of God, you are a mighty man of valor. And you have to know exactly who He has created you to be and allow that to shine through. Yeah, all that other stuff, don't allow yourself to be defined by that stuff. Allow yourself to be defined by this stuff. Yeah, allow yourself to be defined by what He has said about you, not what everybody else is saying about you. And that's what I started off saying, you know, is there something that people define you? And it's not about how people define you, but it is about what He has created you to be. And if you're not allowing that to shine through, then you are leaving it up for others to define you as they would want to define you. I hope this has made sense to somebody. Amen. I hope this has made sense to somebody. That's who you are. Fearfully and wonderfully made, a joint heir with Christ, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a mighty woman of value, of virtue, a mighty man of valor. That's who you are. That's who you are. And so do not allow the remnant of who you are or who you were to define all that you are. Amen. Don't allow the remnant of who you are or who you were to define all that you are. Amen. That's my Tuesday talk. And I pray that it has been some sense or brought some sense of encouragement to someone to remind you that you are more than what you are allowing people to see. There is more to you than what meets the eye. There is more that the Lord is requiring of you than what you are allowing others to see. Yeah, we all have bad days. We all have, you know, low moments, but don't allow that to be the thing that defines you. Because if you allow more of Him to shine through you when you are having those bad days, this who He defined you as comes through more so than those low moments. Who He defined you as comes through more, you know, than those bad days. Yeah, you are more than that. And you've got to walk in the more. Yeah, you've got to walk in the more. Amen. And that's all I needed to say. That's all I wanted to say. You know, we just live in such, again, the social media world. We live in this time where, you know, everybody can screenshot and send and text and what and forward. You know, don't be defined by a moment. Don't be defined by a degree by itself. Don't be defined by just a title. Don't be defined by your past. Don't be defined by what they said. You're so much more than that. Go back to my example. If I just allowed somebody to come and see what I swept up in the middle of my floor, they could leave my house saying, "Oh goodness, she sure keep a dirty house." But I deserve all of that. because I won't allow them to see the rest of the house. That's the same way it is in our spiritual walk. If the only thing they see is your dirt, that's how they're going to define you. You have to show people that you're so much more than that. You have to show people that you do have a good side. You do have a passionate side. You do have a gracious side. You do have a kind side. You know, you do have a loving side. You do have a side that's pleasing unto God. Yeah, we've got to, we are not who they say we are. We are more than that. Amen. 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 That's all I wanted to share. This is my Tuesday talk. And so again, I pray that it was an encouragement to someone. And I pray that we will allow our lights to shine before men. Those of you that work in the public, allow them to see your light. Those of you that have to work within the community, allow them to see your light. For those of you that have to deal with people online and have to go live, allow them to see your light. Allow them to see who God created you to be. Allow them to see the more of you. Amen. 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 That's my Tuesday talk. Again, my time is up. I pray that you've been blessed. If you've been blessed by this word in any way, please consider sowing into Kimberly Moore Ministries. It goes to good ground. And so we can, you can sow it to Cash App KMM707. And we greatly, greatly would appreciate it. Amen. Let's continue to pray for one another. Again, these are different times. These are, and if we allow it to be, discouraging times. But we are going to be the light in the midst of the discouragement. You know, we're going to be the light in the midst of all of the negativity. Let's make up in our minds to be that light. Ask yourself, what's defining you? And do not allow the remnant of who you are to define all that you are. Amen. I love you all with the love of the Lord. Father, bless us now as we prepare to go our separate ways. I pray, Lord God, that you will allow someone listening to my voice to be encouraged by this nugget. I pray, Lord God, that they will be a light in a dark world. I pray, Father, that they will allow you to shine through more than anything else they have going for them. God, we thank you for the great things you've blessed us with. But God, we don't define ourselves by the things, oh God. We define ourselves because of who you are on the inside of us. Oh God, we pray, Lord God, a special covering upon us all as we prepare to go and just do everything that you've assigned us to do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. God bless you all. Again, join us tomorrow night for our Bible study with EMBC. As always, know that I love you all with the love of the Lord, and I so appreciate you spending just a little bit of time with us as we have been able to be a part of this Tuesday Talks. I am Dr. Kimberly Moore, and this has been our Tuesday Talks. If the Lord says the same, we'll see you all same place, same time next week as we share another word, amen, of encouragement as well as a push to get you to your next. All right. Love you all with the love of the Lord. Have a good night, everybody.